morning, children. Now we are in lesson number 5, coordination chemistry. In this lesson, we have discussed about what is coordination compound, how we can differentiate it from double salt, then what are all present in this coordination compounds, central metal atom, ligand, coordination number, the terms we have learned, oxidation state, then counter ions, all those things we have discussed. Then we have learned about Werner's theory. In Werner's theory we have learned about primary valency and secondary valency. Then we have learned about the IUPAC nomenclature, the naming of this coordination compounds we have learned in last class, how we can name. Okay, so first we have named the ligand, next we have named the complex like that we have seen. Okay, now we are going to see the isomerisms exist in this coordination compounds. We know in organic chemistry isomerism exists. Okay, the compounds will have same molecular formula but they will have different structural formula, different structure they will show. For example, cis and trans we have discussed. Then we have discussed chain and iso, okay, iso and N, okay, the long the same molecular formula, it will exist in long chain as well as it will exist in side chain. Okay, chain isomer like that we have learned. Then we have learned about position isomerism, the functional group will occupy different position, metamerism, okay, functional isomerism like that we have discussed in organic chemistry. Here also, in coordination chemistry also, isomerism is taking place. Okay, here how it is taking place? Because of the different arrangement of ligands, this isomerism is taking place in coordination compounds. Okay, so the two or more coordination compounds will have same molecular formula, but the ligands will be arranged in different manner. Because of that, it will show different physical property and chemical properties. Okay. So now we are going to see some types of isomerism which are taking place in coordination compounds. Okay, in coordination compounds, the major classification of isomerism here it is structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. In structural isomerism, okay, because of the arrangement of ligands in different variation, we will get ionization isomerism, hydride isomerism, linkage isomerism, coordination isomerism. Okay, these four types of isomerism exist exhibits by coordination compounds by the arrangement of ligands in different space. Okay, different manner. Okay, so in ionization isomerism, the counter ion also can act as a ligand so that it will replace the ligand position and ligand will go out. But in two compounds, they will have same molecular formula, same the number of ligands, everything will be same. Okay, but the ions will be different. Now we are going to see one by one. Hydride isomerism means water. Okay, the number of water molecules present inside the coordination sphere and outside the sphere will be different. But both compounds will have same number of water molecules. Okay, the next linkage isomerism. It will be exhibited by a ampidentate ligand. Ampidentate, you know the meaning, which can form, a single ligand can form more than one bond, okay, more than one direction. For example, NO2, NO2 can act as a ligand. It can form bond through nitrogen as well as it can form bond through oxygen, okay. It is a monodentate only one template can form bond either by nitrogen side or by oxygen side. Okay, so here the ligand is same NO2 only, but which is binding to the central metal atom, whether the nitrogen or the oxygen. Okay, by this way the isomerism is exhibited there. That is called linkage isomerism. The next one is coordination isomerism. In this coordination isomerism, the ligands attached to the central metal atom will be different. Okay, now we are going to see one by one. Okay, the next is here stereoisomerism. Stereo means the spatial arrangement of ligands in three-dimensional way. Okay, around the central metal atom, how these ligands are arranged in the same ligand. ingredients only, okay, but it will be arranged in different space. Because of that we will get two types of isomerisms. One is geometrical isomerism and another one is optical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism, you know, okay, geometrical means cis and trans, cis isomer and trans isomer. Okay, suppose the similar ligands are occupying the same site, then it will be called as cis. If it is occupying opposite side, then it will be called as trans. Okay, same way optical. Optical isomers, it is nothing but the rotation of plane polarized light by the particular coordination compound solution. Which side it is rotating? Whether it is rotating in left hand side or right hand side. Whether levo rotatory or dextro rotatory. Okay, like that we are going to discuss in this part. Okay, first in this class we are going to talk about structural isomerism. Okay, so what are all structural isomerism? Ionization isomerism, hydrate isomerism, linkage isomerism, and coordination isomerism. Okay, so now let us discuss about this isomerism separately. First, we are going to talk about linkage isomerism. In linkage isomerism, one ligand, it can act as an ambidentate ligand. Ambidentate means it can form either side bond. Okay, it can form both sides. For example, NO2, here in NO2, N double bond O. Okay, this nitrogen also can form bond with the central metal atom cobalt or the oxygen which has extra lone electron. This also can donate its electron from bond with the central metal atom. Okay, so this type of ligands are called as ambidentate ligand. So for linkage isomerism, the ligand, at least one ligand, that ligand must be ambidentate ligand. Then only can exhibit linkage isomerism. Okay, so let us draw this one so we can understand better. See, here cobalt is present as a central metal atom and 5 NH3 molecules. NH3, 5 NH3 molecules as a ligand. Then one more ligand here is NO2, N double bond O. Okay, here N is binding with the central metal atom cobalt. Okay, this is one complex. Okay, the next, the same NO2 also can form bond like this, central metal atoms cobalt. See, carbon is capital letter, oxygen is small letter. Okay, then only it is called as cobalt. If you write both in capital letter, it will become carbon monoxide, carbonyl, like that it will become. Okay, so you have to write capital letter C and small letter O, cobalt. Again, here also the 6 ligands, 5 ligands are NH3. And this ligand is binded to the NO2 group, but here oxygen is forming bond. Okay, so this is called linkage isomerism. In two cases, in both these two coordination compounds, same central metal atom, same number of ligands. Okay, 6 ligands, here also 6 ligands, 5 are ammonia, here also 5 are ammonia, but here another group is here NO2, here also NO2, but here it is linked with nitrogen, here it is linked with oxygen. Okay, so because of that, its physical property, chemical property are differing. Okay, mom? So same molecular formula but different structure. Okay, different structure. Okay, because of that it is showing different property. So this is one type of isomerism. Okay, isomers. So this type of isomerisms are called as linkage isomerism. Okay, next we are going to see coordination isomerism. Okay, coordination isomerism. Coordination isomerism, both both cation and anion both must be complex. The cation also complex and anion also complex. In such type of compounds only can exhibit coordination isomerism. Okay, this is one example here. Cobalt NH3 6 and chromium CN6. Okay, in this complex, this is one coordination compound. Okay, it is not a two compound. Okay, it is not two example also. It is only one example. When you are writing here, you have to write together. Okay, combining this, for example, the next one here, chromium NH3 6 cobalt CN6. Okay, so when they are asking you to write the coordination isomerism, you have to write it fully. Okay, this fully, it is together, this is a one example, it is not single example. Okay, you have to write fully. Okay, so in first case, this is one compound, this is another compound. In the first compound, it is cation, it is anion. Here in this cationic complex, cobalt is a single metal atom which is attached to the 6th amine group. Here it is chromium, it is attached to the, it forms bond with the 6 cyanide molecules there. But in the second case, same here chromium and single metal atom, 6 amines are there. Here also cobalt and 6 cyanides are there. But if you notice here, the ligands are arranged in different way. In first case, amines are arranged with cobalt. In second example, it is arranged with the chromium. Here, the cyan is arranged with the chromium here. Here, the cyan is arranged with the cobalt. Okay. So, the ligands are arranged with the different central metal atoms. But, same molecular formula. In first compound also, one cobalt, one chromium, 6 amine, 6 cyanide. In second compound also, one chromium, one cobalt, 6 amine, 6 cyanide. Same molecular formula, but the ligands are arranged in the different way to the central metal atom. This type of isomerisms are called as coordination isomerism. To exhibit coordination isomerism, the compound must have cationic complex and anionic complex. Both must be complex. In such cases only, this type of isomerism can be exhibited. Okay. The next isomerism here, ionization isomerism. Okay, in ionization isomerism, the ionizable counter ion, it should also act as a ligand. Okay, in Werner's theory, we have learned, no, primary and secondary valency, like that, the inner shell, outer shell one is called as ionizable, and the ions which is present are loosely binded, like that we have learned, which is present in inner shells, it is binded very firmly, and those are called as ligands, like that we have learned. Okay, so here we are going to see the ionizable ion which is present in the outer sphere is also act as a ligand. Okay, it has the tendency to act as a ligand. Ligand means what? It must have the lone pair of electron with it. Then only it can donate its electron to the central metal atom and can form bond, isn't it? Okay, so here for ionization isomerism, ionization isomerism, the counter ion must have the tendency to act as a ligand. Counter ion is acting as a ligand. Okay, in such time we can get this type ionization isomerism. Just for example here, chromium here 4 amine group and Cl Br NO2. Okay, so this is my coordination compound. In this compound, the central metal atom is chromium and the ligands are here 4 amine group and 1 chlorine group and 1 Br. Okay, so coordination number is how much here? 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. Totally 6 ligands are present. Okay, so coordination number is here 6. Okay, it's enclosed with the square bracket. Now this NO2 is called as counter ion. Okay, NO2 is called as here counter ion, which is loosely binded outside the sphere. Okay, but the segment can also act as a ligand. As a before in linkage isomerism, we have that N-group is acting as a ligand there. Okay, so it can act as a ligand. So in the next complex, if you notice here, is another example. In this case, chromium NH3 4 Cl, N-group 2 Br. Okay, so in this example, if you notice here same sentimental atom, here 4-amine, 1-chloro, here NO2 is present, but here bromine is acting as a counter ion. But when you are looking at these two coordination compounds, both are having equal number of molecules, okay, equal number of chromium, equal number of amine, chlorine, NO2, Br, everything is an equal number. But the ionizable ions are different. In first case, when you are ionizing, you will get NO2 ion, okay, NO2 minus ion. When you are ionizing the second compound, the solution you will get Br minus ion. Okay, so from this we can say the ions which is coming in the solution are different. Okay, so this type of isomerisms are called as ionization isomerism. Okay, so the ions liberated outside are different, but the molecular formulas are same. Okay, this type of isomerisms are called as ionization isomerism. Okay, so for ionization isomerisms, what is the concept here? The counter ion must act as a ligand. It must have the capability of acting as a ligand. Then only this type of isomerism can be exhibited. Okay. The next isomerism here, solvate isomerism or hydrate isomerism. Hydrate or solvate. Hydrate means it will belong to only water. So generally they are writing as solvate, not only water, other solvent also. Alcohol. Okay, some other solvents, okay, whatever solvent we are using, or it will be belongs to all. Okay, so simply we can write hydrate or solvate isomerism. Okay, here the solvent, the hydrate, the water molecule present in the coordination complex will be differ. Okay, now let me give some example. When the number of water molecules are differing, the color also is changing. Okay, because of the water molecule number is decreasing or increasing, based on that the color also is differing. Here it is 1 mark also. Okay, so just note down here Cr H2O 6 Cl 3. It is actually violet color. Next one here, Cr H2O 5 Cl and Cl2 H2O. It is pale green color. Can you see the difference between these two compounds now? See the next compound, Cr H2O 4 Cl2 Cl 2 H2O. Okay, 2 H2O. This is dark green color. Dark green color. Now see here, if you notice here, in first case, 6 water molecules are present as a ligand, and 3 chlorines are present as a ions. Okay, it is present as a counter ion, which is present outside the square bracket. Okay, in the next case, if you notice here, 1 water molecule is present outside the sphere, and 1 chlorine is present inside the coordination sphere, which now it is acting as a ligand. This water molecule is acting as a counter ion there. Okay, so now if you compare all these three, you can see same number of chromium. All are having only 1 chromium. All are having 6 water molecules. Here also 6. Here also 6. Here 4 plus 2, 6. All are having 6 water molecules. All are having 3 Cl. Okay, but what is the difference here? The number of water molecules present inside the coordination sphere is differing here. Okay, here 6, here 4, 5, here it is 4. Because of that, we are getting different color there. When it is 6, it is violet color. When it is 5, it is pale green, and before it is dark green. Okay, so its physical properties changing there. Okay, so it is exhibiting the isomerism, same molecular formula but different structures. Okay, different arrangements are taking place because the ligands are arranged in different manner there. Okay, so this type of isomerisms are called as hydride isomerism or solvate isomerism. Okay, children, this is very very important. Okay, you can get in 2-mark question. In 5-mark, they can ask write about the structure isomerism of coordination chemistry, like that also they can ask. You have to write all the 4: linkage isomerism, coordination isomerism, ionization isomerism, hydride isomerism. But we can expect in 2-mark question or 3-mark question as a single topic. Okay, you have to give example, you have to explain what it is, then you have to write the example also. Okay children, so I hope you have understood what is isomerism and what is structural isomerism, then what are the types of structural isomerism, then each isomerism with example I have explained. I hope you have understood. Just go through it. Okay children, thank you.